So I'm just getting ready to skin the boat. And the first thing we want to do is make sure that we don't have any nails or screws sticking out from the plane of where the skin's going to touch. You can just run your finger over it, or you can run a ruler over it. We sewed up the stern. And we need to move the entire swath of fabric about 3 fingers, very unscientific, but that width, that way, towards the bow. And then we're going to sew the other end up, and that allows us to basically make a sock that's too small for the boat. I'm going to slide the fabric towards the bow, about 3 fingers width. Now we're ready to sew up the bow. If this part of the fabric takes the wrong run, the wrong trajectory, it's gonna go, you know, either up like that, and that ain't right, or down here, and you can see that ain't right, wrinkles. So pull the trajectory to a point where it minimizes wrinkles. I'm gonna put some needles to hold it where I want it. See that crease? That's not good. That's better, right? The fabric departs from the keel and the stem right about here, right where it starts to form a little mohawk. And I'm going to be using a piece of artificial sinew that's about a fathom and a half long. So I'm going to do a stitch that's about a finger width. Pinch the little mohawk, stab, get the needle coming through so it's parallel to the front facet of the stem. And your mohawk should be centered on the middle of that, the front of the stem, like that. Finger width, pinch that mohawk, and stab it. Just want to pinch it together. Cut in a little bit there, so you can grab the little tip, create some tension, and then just do your best not to get too high as you're breathing all this garbage from right in your lungs. I just exhale the whole time. Like Bill Clinton. Wrapping the fabric like this. And I think the tighter you roll this, the better it looks. So get a nice tight roll. Find your stitch spacing. Stab. And pull. At the origin, I like to finish that with another whipping as well. Just a little one. Okay, so now we're done sewing up both ends. We'll remove the fabric and soak it in cold, clean water for about 15 minutes. Don't crumple it up, because then you'll have a tie-dye boat. Skin soaked for at least 15 minutes in cold, clean water. We sewed it up a little too short for the boat on purpose. Water relaxes the fibers so they can elongate. We're going to take advantage of that. Get it on there while it's wet. And then when it dries, it'll shrink up. I'm going to actually hook the bow first. As a moment of truth, we see if we sewed it too short or if I can actually get it back on what it's supposed to be. It's a good sign. So the tension starting at that point, so I'm going to pull it down the last couple inches. Now we can flip it over. So to get the tension in the fabric around the girth of the boat, we're going to use what we call a corset stitch.